It's time to redeem myself for this horrendously proportioned carousel horse from 2019. Hello and welcome back to Jenna Gets Creative. It's the third Friday of the month, and that means it's time for an Art Addicts Alliance video. This month's theme choices are a redraw or the prompt, Spring is Coming. I decided to do a redraw, and this one immediately came to mind. This was from a ScrawlrBox in October 2019, the one that featured art from Drawing with Waffles, and it was a purple Copic Chow sketch pack. So I'm going to keep the purple marker theme, but let myself use a wider variety of markers. I'll talk more about the piece and the supplies in a minute, but let's talk about the Art Addicts Alliance first. If you're not familiar with the Art Addicts Alliance, we are a group of art-focused YouTube channels who get together on the third Friday of every month to upload art based on a chosen theme, give each other shoutouts, and just have fun. The other current official members besides myself are Jazz Capri, Weblight Dreams, Pan Dimensional Space Zombie, All Funnies and Games, Aurora's Art World, Blue Flynn, The Artsy Pineapple, Justin Dwyer Artistry, Enjoy Drawing with Mary, and Dark Star Creations. Everyone's channel links are in the description down below, so please do go check them out and see what everyone else has done with this month's themes after this video. We don't have an official guest this month, but we do like to feature guest artists, so if you're interested in guesting with us, please do join our Discord server and apply. You can also join the server just to hang out with fellow artists and chat. There's an invite link in the description box and the pinned comment. If you're interested in being a featured artist, we just ask that you're an active YouTuber with a focus on art content. You'll be told what the month's theme is ahead of time, and you'll upload at the same time as us. We'll include you in our shoutouts, and you'll mention us, and it'll be fun. If you'd like to join us on a permanent basis, then we do ask that you have at least 100 subscribers, and we'll need to see an audition video. Your audition video can be your featured guest video if you guested with us before. It can be an unofficial guest video that you upload just for fun on one of our upload weekends, or you can do one of our past themes at any time. Don't feel like you can't apply if your art doesn't look like everyone else's on the team. We love variety, we've had a lot of different styles on the team in the Art Addicts Alliance history, and there's no minimum skill level requirement or anything like that. The audition is just so we can see how you would handle the monthly videos, and so that the current members casting their vote are all voting based on the same thing. Most applicants end up joining us. We'd love to fill the roster to the maximum of 15, and we've currently got 4 spots open, so now is the perfect time to apply if you've ever been interested. Permanent members are asked to join our Discord server for communication purposes, participate in suggesting themes for the monthly theme poll and vote on those polls, and participate in the monthly upload as often as possible. If life gets in the way or the month's theme really doesn't work for you, missing here and there is fine. Just pop onto the server and let us know. We're pretty chill. A couple of months back, we decided we're doing the top 2 winning themes on the poll rather than just the 1 winning theme each month. So don't worry about not being inspired by the themes too frequently either. We have options now. Anyway, moving on, I'd like to tell you about the giveaways I have coming up before we get back to talking about this piece. The first is my Let's Get Jenna Monetized giveaway, and that one will open when this channel has the watch hours for monetization. The prize will be your choice of a prize pack plus a small original artwork, and the prize pack choices are the art supplies I've been setting aside for a giveaway, the fantasy genre duplicates I have on my bookshelf, or a book depository order placed on your behalf. The second giveaway is the Let's Get Jenna to 2K giveaway, and that one will open once this channel has reached and stayed at or above 2,000 subscribers for a few days. The prize for that one will be an Amazon gift card or a book depository order. Winners from both contests do need to be subscribed to this channel to win, and all possible prizes, except for the Amazon gift card, will require that you're able and willing to provide your mailing address privately with me if you win. More details for both giveaways are in the description box down below, and I'll be making a dedicated video soon to spread the word. For now, what you can do to help those giveaways happen as soon as possible is to make sure you're subscribed and watching my videos all the way through, hit the like button, leave comments, and maybe even share videos with your friends. Okay, now the piece. So that original carousel horse was drawn on Canson the Wall paper, which I had never worked with before. It's designed to be ideal for alcohol markers, in that absolutely nothing bleeds through to the other side, and that's achieved by making it so densely thick that even though it's white and doesn't already have pigment in it, you can put it on top of a drafting light table in a dark room and not be able to see anything through it. Really cool paper! if you freehand your sketch directly on your final paper and don't prep elsewhere. It didn't allow for effective erasing, so my piece was already a mess before I even started trying to finalize line art, and I'm used to being able to finalize my drawings on paper I don't care about and trace it over to the fancier paper, so I don't have erasing messes left behind on the final piece. On top of how messy that combination of supplies made my sketching, I was trying very hard to stick to only the carousel horse references I could find on Pixabay, and I wanted an all four hooves off the ground pose, so I was very limited in what I could draw, and frankly, the reference photo I picked was of a fairly ugly carousel horse to begin with. Whoever carved it quite possibly hadn't actually ever seen a galloping horse before, and didn't know what to do with the back legs, but for some reason, I copied that. So I had a messy half-erased sketch, I had back leg anatomy that didn't make sense based on a disproportionate real carousel horse, and then I was only allowed to color it with two Copic markers, a Spica glitter pen, a Copic multiliner, and a Derwent white paint pen. It's a hot mess. I was quite offended at the time when some teenager on the amiibo communities I used to share in mansplained horse anatomy to be helpful, but in retrospect, they were judging based on a pretty ugly piece and hadn't snooped through my gallery to see all of the much more correct horses I had posted before, so I kinda get it. I wouldn't have mansplained it to someone else, but with the distance and added wisdom of 2 years, I see what they saw. And then Redraw was picked as one of our March Art Addicts Alliance themes, and I immediately thought of that ugly carousel horse I've been trying to forget about. Time to redeem myself. I drew this new post based on a decorative figurine rather than an actual ride component, because the ornamental miniature carousel horses tend to be more delicate and pretty. They don't have to support weight or withstand centrifugal forces. The one I was looking at is covered in roses, and I didn't want to bother with that level of detail, so I switched to bows and ribbons, but I put some little daisy-type flowers on the bridle just to add a nod to the source inspiration. I decided to stick to just my Ohuhu markers in the spirit of the limited supply challenge ScrawlrBoxes are, and I decided that the body of the unicorn could only be purple in honor of the original color scheme. I picked pinks for the decorative detail because the glitter pen was pink, and I used buttercup yellow as a base to go under my gold gel pen for the details that made sense to be gold. I allowed myself the gold gel pen because I wasn't using a glitter pen this time, so a metallic pen made sense as a good alternative, and carousel horses usually have gold on them somewhere. Finally, the white eye shine was added using a Sakura jelly roll, and the line art was built up and finalized using some black Copic multiliners. The paper is Transotype coated marker paper, which is exactly the same thing as Copic branded thin marker paper. So not only was this piece a redraw, I did mostly limit myself to the same sort of supplies as the original challenge it was made for. I just allowed myself a larger palette for the pink and purple markers and more nib sizes for the fine liners. I definitely like this new version a lot more, and although I really like the more detailed and polished look I was able to achieve with a larger variety of markers and pens, I think it's all in the base drawing underneath the color. I took a little more time with this drawing, I used a nicer reference, and I was able to actually do all my tweaking and erasing somewhere else and trace it over cleanly to the final sheet. I think even if I had just busted out the supplies from that old ScrawlrBox after and colored it with just the two purple markers, the wine shade liner, the pink glitter pen, and the white paint pen, I still would have been much happier with this version. Thank goodness I didn't take the redraw that extreme though, because I did not want more pink glitter. I've already been finding glitter on my hands as it is, and all I did was the 12 seconds of handling that old piece at the beginning of this video. A 2-year-old completely dry piece at that. No thanks! Plus, I seem to remember the last time I broke out that glitter pen to stand in for something on a no-box art-box challenge, it seemed like it was getting dried out, even though it's been capped all this time and certainly isn't getting used. Do I recommend Spica pens? Heck no. Anyway, thank you for indulging me in this redraw and ramble. Be sure to check out the other Art Addicts Alliance videos today and over the weekend. You can find all the channel links you need in the description box and the pinned comment, and you can also find the theme poll for April and an invite code to our Discord server down there as well. If you're looking for more to watch, I've got some suggestions up on the left side of the screen now. Don't forget to like, comment, maybe even subscribe, and if you like living life creatively, whatever that means to you, I'd love to have you along for the ride. Bye guys!